Good morning, everybody. It's Janet. Just want to give you a really quick how-to cooking video, and I'll be right back with it in 30 seconds. Thank you. Bye. I see I'm too late. Got nothing in my brain. That's what people say. That's what people say. I go on too many dates, but I can't. Hi, thanks for tuning in with Janet McCue. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a roux. All you need for a basic roux is one stick of butter or margarine and half a cup of flour. Whatever size of roux you make, use equal amounts of butter and flour, and of course you need a skillet on your stove. So I've already started melting my butter for expediency because who wants to watch butter melt? So let me see if I can tilt this down a little. There's my butter. And I usually don't measure, but I am measuring today because I'm trying to teach you how to do it right. So, there's my half cup measuring cup. I'm going to put most of it in. Now what you're looking for, I use a whisk because it blends it better. And you don't just blend it and say, oh, it's done. Your flour has to cook, okay? So you have to cook your flour down, has to cook in, brown a little bit. The browner your roux gets, the better the flavor is going to be. This is the base for pretty much any gravy that I make. I've never actually made a gravy with cornstarch. I know people do. I'm just not one of those people. Now I usually use just a little bit less flour. Just seems to work out better for me. My stove goes from low to high. The last number on it is 8, and I've got mine on about 3.5 right now. So, it's a little on the moist side, but I like that. I would rather cook it down a little bit, let it brown, let it cook the flour in. I've probably got about a tablespoon of flour left. Like I said, your basic recipe, though, is equal parts. If it's a small amount, you're making one for one. If it's a larger amount, I usually use just a little bit less flour than I do butter or margarine. Just kind of spread that out. I'm going to hit pause while that cooks down for just a few minutes because it's not an instant thing. This takes a little bit, and then I'll show you what it looks like as it continues to cook. Okay, I'm back. I turned my heat down and I added a little bit more butter because it was looking a little dry for me. And then I switched to my spatula so that I could squish any flour in my pan without worrying about scratching my pan. But I got the color that I wanted. Let me see if I can get, if you can see, it's got a nice golden color. The flour cooked out so that it doesn't have that grainy flour taste to it. And this will be just perfect in my gravy for my pan drippings. This is good if you ever had milk gravy growing up as a kid. This is how, like, my mom and grandma made milk gravy. This is turkey gravy, beef dripping gravy, pot roast gravy, pork roast gravy. We called it shit on shingle gravy. But again, that's just milk gravy. Any type of gravies growing up when you didn't like cornstarch, which I don't like cornstarch gravy, this is how we made it. Butter and flour for normal, say a cup or maybe a cup and a half of drippings. This is gonna, you know, juice, not grease, juice. This is gonna take about 2 tablespoons, maybe 3 tablespoons of butter and flour. Again, I use a little less flour than I do butter. And if you are making a roux out of your pan drippings, you can take and instead of butter, use your bacon grease to do this. You can use your chicken drippings if you make fried chicken. If you make pork chops, you can do the exact same thing. Drain most of your grease out, leave your crumblies in, add a little bit of flour, whisk it up real nicely, slowly add your milk in, and that is the best gravy. I'm not saying it's the healthiest, but it is really good gravy to go with mashed potatoes for special occasions. Not something I would eat all the time. But this is your basic roux. And it's going to go in a... Whoops. Let me get my camera straight again. It's going to go into basic turkey gravy, pan gravy of whatever type you decide to make. I'm going to make turkey gravy. So... And then the rest of this can go in the refrigerator. You can even freeze this, okay? That's part of the reason I like it a little moister, even though some people say, oh, you can't freeze this. I have successfully frozen this in an old ice cube tray, and it's just about the right size for a typical batch of gravy. When you put it in a cube and about like that, put that in an ice cube tray. Once it's frozen, take it out and put it in a Ziploc bag. Okay, that's about the right size for gravy. Put it in, let it thaw, warm it up, get it so it's looking like that again, and then take and add your drippings to it. So, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I enjoyed making it. I love making homemade stuff, as I'm sure you've known by now. Look for my next video coming soon, and again, I hope you enjoyed learning how to make a homemade roux from butter or margarine and flour. You don't need to add any seasonings at this point because those are coming from your juices or drippings or whatever you're adding to it naturally. So have a blessed day. I'll see you soon. Bye. Hi everybody, it's Janet. Hope you enjoyed that how-to cooking video. I really appreciate you watching my channel. Please like, subscribe, and don't forget if you're looking for ways to how-to videos on how to cook, makeup tips, how to save money, make money, whatever it is, follow the links below. Like, subscribe to my YouTube channel here, or go to my website, janetmccue.com, JanetMccue.com. Thanks. Bye.